I'm strong.
Good morning, friendship.
I'm wise.
107th number of Psalms, verse 8 says, oh, that men would praise the Lord for his goodness and for his wonderful works to the children of men. And it goes on to list all the things that God had done for the nation at that time. And as I look back over my life and I see that all that God has done for me, I can't help but praise the Lord. So I want to ask you a question today. How many are here to praise the Lord? How many, as you look back over your life, you realize that you're not here because you've been so good, but you are here because God is good and he deserves all of our praise. Praise the Lord today. Let us bow for a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we come to you today just giving you thanks and praise for all you've done. Thank you for last night's lying down and this morning's rising to find that we have health, strength, sound mind, and the family circle still intact. Father, we now ask that you would just clear our hearts and minds, allow us to be on one accord praising your name today. Father, we ask that you would just forgive us for our sins and anything we've done is not pleasing to you. Clear our hearts and minds, O Lord, and let us truly praise your name today. Bless this service and every service stands open in your name. Bless every prayer that is prayed, every song that is sung, and most of all, bless your preached word. For it's in the name of Jesus Christ, do pray and ask it all. Amen. Let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Now the hands of our deacons.
Good morning. Deacon James, this is Deacon in Training Tate. We're at Lead Your Devotion this morning. And our scripture this morning is coming from Ephesians, chapter 4, verses 1 through 6 and 32. And it reads this way. I, therefore, the prisoner of the Lord, beseech you that you walk worthy of the vocation wherewith you are called, with all lowliness and meekness, with long-suffering, forbearing one another in love, endeavoring to keep the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. There is one body and one Spirit, even as you are called in one hope of your calling, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all and through all, and in you all. And be ye kind one to another, tenderhearted, forgiving one another, even as God for Christ's sake hath forgiven you. I've read to you Ephesians chapter 4, verses 1 through 6 and 32. May the Lord have a blessing on the readers, the hearers, and doers of his holy word.
Amen. Let us pray. Father God, we just thank you, Lord God. Just let us see another day, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God, just for another opportunity, Lord God, to be, Father God, here in your house, Lord God. Father God, we come for you just, Lord, ask for forgiveness. Anything we did or said or thought that was wrong in your eyesight, Lord God, forgive us, Lord God. Give us a renewing mind, a clean heart, Lord God, that we can worship you in spirit and truth, Lord God. It's all about you, Lord God, not about us, Lord God. We put all our issues aside, and we give them all to you, Lord God. Father God, you the way maker, Lord God. Father God, you, Father God, the burden bearer, Lord God. Who can we call on? Who can we run to? It's only you, Lord God. And we thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God, for the ones, Father God, that may be on their way, Lord God. Bless them in the name of Jesus, Lord God. Bless them the ones that's here, Lord God. Bless their household. Bless their families. We pray in the name of Jesus, Lord God, for the pastor, his wife, for the deacons, Father God, for the members, for the guests that's here, Lord God. We pray, Father God, that we uplift your name in the name of Jesus, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God. It's only you, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God, for all what you do in our life. Thank you, Lord God, the ones that will be here will be healed. Father God, they may need a financial blessing, Lord God. Whatever it may be, Lord God, you the answer. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Amen.
Can we all stand on our feet? Oh, how excellent is the name of Jesus. Can we give him a hand clap of praise? Oh, how precious is the name of Jesus. He is so worthy to be praised and honored on this day. Let's all just give God a big hand clap of praise. How many of y'all excited to be here this morning? If you are, raise your hand. He's allowed us all to see another day. Nothing that was promised from us. Everybody put your hands together.
God Almighty.
Thank you. give myself to you. Thank y'all for joining in our devotion.
Good morning. Giving reverence to God our Father, Jesus Christ our Savior, and to the Holy Spirit our Comforter, to Pastor Trotter and Sister Trotter, to the ministers on the roster, and to the deacons who labor with them, and to the Friendship family. My name is Elena Ford, and these are your announcements for August 23rd, 2015. During the month of August, we will not have Old Time Gospel Hour. Old Time Gospel Hour will resume during September. Wednesday Bible study will be held at 9:30 a.m. and at 7 p.m. August 29th, intercessory prayer breakfast, child care will be provided. August 30th, prison ministry will visit Lindsay State Jail. Contact Reverend Donnie Devereaux for more details. Registration has begun the Broken Session beginning September 8th. If you're interested, please contact Reverend James Jenkins at the sign-up table in the FLC following service today. Warriors for God will open the McBride Bookstore at 11 a.m. For more information or to make a donation, contact Brother Peter Burns or Brother Ron McGee. September 20th, pastoral installation for Reverend Audrey Williams at 4:30 p.m., Providence Missionary Baptist Church, Montalba, Texas. Financial Peace University will begin Tuesday, September 22nd. The class is open to FBCT members and the surrounding community. There is no cost for sign-up, but a kit must be purchased to take the 9-week course. Contact Sister Thiadine Hernandez for additional information. Third Pastor and Wife Appreciation Celebration, honoring Reverend Gregory Trotter and the First Lady Doris Trotter, Sunday, September 27th, 11 a.m. Guest speaker, Pastor Jerry W. Daly, Macedonia Missionary Baptist Church, San Antonio, Texas. Theme, The Steps of a Godly Man, Psalms 37:23. Please govern yourselves accordingly, Pastor Trotter and the body of Friendship Baptist Church of the Colony. Church announcements can be found in your church bulletin or the church bulletin board, or log on to www.friendshipbaptistofthecolony.org. And now, a memorable quote from our pastor's desk. You can't stand up to Satan if you don't kneel before God. Thank you, and have a blessed day.
Good morning, everybody. Oh, come on and put those blessed hands together. How are you this morning? Isn't he good? Isn't the Lord good? I don't know about you, but I thank him because the blood still works. Isn't he good? Oh, give thanks unto the Lord. Oh, come on and magnify him with me this morning. Oh, I'm getting excited now. Just as I say the words, I remember the scriptures and I remember the songs. And one of those that gets us going is the blood still works. Well, I'm standing here. Oh, thank you, Pastor, for this opportunity. Give honor to God who is ahead of my life, the Son, Jesus Christ, and the blessed Holy Spirit, and appreciation to all of you who labor here for the work of the Lord. I'm Aleon, hi, standing on behalf of your music ministry, and I want to invite all of you to our 2015 praise and worship experience. We're going to have a workshop, we're going to have a prayer breakfast, we're going to have a musical, and it is all a dynamic experience like never before. Won't you come and join us? Yeah? All right, the dates are September 10th through the 12th. All of the events are here at our church, FBC, and there's no cost to attend. However, if the Lord moves it upon your heart to donate and support your ministry, we would graciously accept it and appreciate you for your support. Let me tell you what's going to happen. Thursday night at 6:30, we're having a workshop. Our guest clinician is Stellar Award nominee Malcolm Williams. That's the guy who wrote The Blood Still Works. Oh, give thanks to the Lord. All those songs that we sing and give honor to God in our service. Now, that's Thursday night. On Friday night at 6:30, we're workshopping again. Saturday morning at 9, we're meeting here in our gym, and Evangelist Teresa M. Brown will be with us, giving us a word that will inspire us and encourage us spiritually so we can better deliver when we're in the choir stand here for you. Now, later on that night at 6 p.m. here in the sanctuary, all of the workshop choir. So that means you don't have to be in Unified to sing and participate. It's for everybody. We're going to sing and answer the call in Colossians 3:16 to let the love of Christ dwell richly in all of us, to sing songs, spiritual songs and hymns with gratefulness, thankfulness in our hearts to God. It's singing to give thanks. You're all invited. Meet us in the corridor to register. We love you, and I know I'll see all of you there. God bless.
love the name.
Good morning, friendship. Giving honor to God, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit, who is definitely in this place this morning. Giving respects to Pastor Trotter, Sister Trotter, and the ministers and deacons who proudly labor in the word with them. My name is Jalen Harris, and I'm here on behalf of the Hospitality Committee to welcome our guests. If you are currently not a member of Friendship Baptist Church and you are visiting here for the first time, or you have been here before, we ask that you please stand and remain standing at this time. There is no day like a day to praise the Lord, and we are so thankful that you chose today to share that experience with us. Here at Friendship, the doors are always open. Every question will be asked, and every need through God will be supplied. Friendship family, please stand and welcome our guests.
Now we'll have a special announcement from our program committee. Amen.
Good morning, Friendship family. Good morning. I'm Deacon Henry McDonald. This is my wife, Mary McDonald.
Good morning, Friendship. We're here on the behalf of the program committee to provide you with additional information regarding our pastors and wife upcoming third appreciation service. Amen. The celebration will be held September the 27th at 11 a.m. Our theme is The Steps of a Godly Man. Psalms 37 and 23 is our reference scripture. Our colors will be brown and cream. Our guest speaker will be Pastor Jerry Daly from Missionary Baptist Church in San Antonio, Texas.
Now, we realize that on a special occasion such as this, everyone would like the opportunity to express their love and appreciation for our pastor and first lady. However, in essence of time, we do want to be considerate. Therefore, we have set up a table in our gymnasium for expressions of love and or gifts to be placed on. And we pray that everyone will follow our instructions. Thank you.
Also, earlier this month, I placed a letter in each auxiliary's mailbox with detailed information on our protocol for presentations. If anyone have any questions, please feel free to contact me at the number listed on the letter. Amen?
Amen.
Thank you for your kind attention. Please have a spiritual renewed day.
Amen. Good morning, Friendship.
Good morning.
We greet you in the name of Jesus the Christ as we thank God for another Lord's Day that he has allowed us to see and to be a part of. Amen. We want to say to those of you, our guests who are sharing with us today, welcome to Friendship. We are so glad to have you a part of this worship service, and we invite you to come back and share with us again. Amen. As young Brother Harris said, if there's anything we can do to make your stay here more enjoyable, please don't hesitate to ask. Those who are joining us by live streaming, we welcome you into this worship service as well. You heard all of our announcements. On this coming Saturday morning at 9 o'clock, we will be having a prayer breakfast. Amen. Here at the church, beginning at 9 o'clock from 9 to 12. So we are inviting you to come out and share, amen, in this prayer breakfast. Amen. There'll be a word of encouragement, and there will be a time of praying. Amen. Let me tell you one thing that's always in order, and that is prayer.
Amen.
Amen. Praying is never out of order. Amen. So we're going to set aside some time this coming Saturday morning, amen, for a prayer breakfast. Also, you heard the announcement of Southern Bible Institute registration. It still goes on today. The class, the evangelism class, will start this Tuesday at 6:30. So those of you who may not have already signed up, there will be a sign-up table over in the Family Life Center. Also, on the third Sunday in September, Reverend Archery Williams will be installed as the pastor of the Providence Baptist Church down in Mount Alba, Texas. And we are asking as many of you that can to come and go with us. Amen. You've been asking the question, are we going to get a bus? No, we are not going to do that. But we are going to go, I pray, in numbers to show our support to Pastor and Sister Archery Williams. Amen. Amen. It's back to school, children.
Amen.
Amen. And your parents act like they are sad, but I know they're just as happy on the inside as they can be. Amen. That it's back to school. Amen. We are praying for our children as they prepare to go back into the schools. Amen. Summer break is over. Amen. Now reality, amen, sets in once again. So we are going to be praying for our children as they get ready to go back to school. We thank God that he is omnipresent. That means he's everywhere. Amen. He's at our home, but he's also in our schools. And when we can't watch our children, he watches them for us. Amen. And that's the reason why we need to put our children in the hands of the Lord. And I thank God for our young people this morning. They've done a marvelous job. Amen. They've done a great job this morning. In singing. And as I looked at that young man helping out, leading the song, I thought that's the time we need to catch them. Amen. We try to catch them when they've gotten old and their minds made up. Amen. But that's the time that we need to catch them and instill in them the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Because he's the only one that's going to be able to help them as they go throughout life. Amen. Our deacons are going to come at this time as we prepare to receive our tithes and our offering. Here at Friendship, we believe in tithes and we believe in offering. Amen. The tithe is that which we owe God. The offering is the seed that we sow. And we thank God for this opportunity to be obedient to what he said to us in his word. We also receive our contributions to our building fund and to our mortgage cancellation. Our deacons are going to pray, and then our ushers and deacons will receive the tithe and the offering.
Let us pray. Most gracious Heavenly Father, we just want to take a moment to say thank you, Father. Thank you for this opportunity just to give back, Father, a portion of what you blessed us with, Father. We ask that you use these tithes and offerings for the uplifting of your kingdom on this side, Father. Bless those that had a desire to give that had it not. Bless those that have it to give, Father. Father, we ask that you bless us, watch over us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. This morning we are going to ask all of our children, those who are getting ready to go back to school, to come to the altar at this time. We are going to have a special time of prayer for all of our children. Come on, parents, with your children. Amen. As they come to the altar. Amen. We are going to plead God's protection up over and up on our children. Amen. Amen. There's plenty of room at the altar. Amen. This is altar call. Everyone standing. We're going to ask Reverend Michael Webb, our youth minister, to come and to pray God's blessings and his protection upon our children. Amen.
May we all bow. Heavenly Father, we come to you today in the most humble manner that we know how. Father, we first just acknowledge you as God, and beside thee there isn't another. Father, there's no one else that we can call on, Father, that can do anything. Father, we just thank you for your grace and your mercy. Thank you for all that you are doing, all that you have done, and we thank you in advance for what we know you're going to do. Father, now we come before you, Lord, just praying a special prayer upon our young people. Father, whatever age they are, Father, we know that they need you. Satan is on the attack. He wished to lead them astray, Father. But Father, we ask that you would put a fence of protection around them like only you can. Father, protect them from all dangers, seen as well as unseen. Lead them away from anything or anyone who wishes to lead them astray, Father. Father, we ask that you would just give them the strength to say no when they need to say no. We ask that you would just give them the conviction to run away when they need to flee. And most of all, we ask, Lord, you would give them the strength to stand where they need to stand and let someone know who they stand for. Father, we ask that you would just give them strength to do well in school. Lord, allow them to make good grades, Father. We ask that you would just give them strength, oh Lord, to where they may be an example to others who are their age, Father, so that they may see the light that is within them, Father. We ask that you would just put your hands of protection around them, oh Lord. Give them peace. Guide their attitudes, oh Lord, the words that they speak, oh Lord, the things they do. We ask, oh Lord, that we just bring them to you, oh Lord, and we ask that you would just hold them in the palm of your hand, Father. Father, we just thank you in advance for what we know you're going to do. You're doing great things to our young people, Father. And we ask that you would just continue to use them in a special way. Now, Father, we pray for everyone else who under the sound of my voice. Father, some may be sick. We ask that you would just give healing. We ask you, Lord, that you would just deliver them from whatever may be holding them in bondage, Father. Father, we ask that you would just move in a special way upon this congregation. And, oh, Lord, we just claim it. We just consider it done, Father. We know that you have all power, and we know that you can do anything, Father. And we just claim it and consider it done right now. For it's in Jesus' name we do pray. Amen.
Psalms 121, a very familiar passage of scripture. Psalms 121. Psalms 121, and we'll read all 8 verses. Because we'll cover all 8 verses. Does not mean we're going to be here a long time. We're going to say a word and take our seat. I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills from which cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord which made heaven and earth. He will not suffer thy foot to be moved. He that keepeth thee will not slumber. Behold, he that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is thy shade upon thy right hand. The sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy soul. The Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in from this time forth and even forevermore. May the Lord bless the reader, the hearers, and the doers of his word. Father in heaven, we thank you again for this privilege that you've given to us. It's a blessed privilege to be in your house of worship today. And we say thank you. We thank you, Lord, for not only being here, but Lord, we thank you for being able to come together and worship you in spirit and in truth. Now we pray your blessings upon this hour of preaching. Lord, we give ourselves wholeheartedly and completely unto you. We ask that you would just have your way. Let the word that goes forth today encourage the hearts and the minds of your people. Use us for your glory. And we'll take none for ourselves, but give it all unto you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. As we give glory, honor, and praise to God Almighty, to Jesus Christ, my Savior, to the Holy Spirit who comforts, keeps, and who guides me, and to our ministers and deacons, and to all of you that are present today, we greet you in the name of Jesus. Today, for just a little while, we are going to talk about the benefits of trusting God. Amen. The benefits of trusting God. We live in a time when our world today believes in a little God and a big humanity. What this means is that our world pays more attention to what man says than what God says. You see, man has tried to take the place of God. With all of man's inventions and scientific progress, he feels that he is outgrowing the need for God. Now, God in our world today is being pushed into the background. Just the other day, a well-known athlete came out of the closet and said he's an atheist and that he don't believe in God. Every time we turn around, there's someone else coming out of the closet with something they believe or don't believe, something they are or someone they are not. And it's all because we are allowing God to be pushed into the background. Now, I think it's time for real Christians to come out of the closet. Can I get a witness? You see, I believe that if the Christians would come out of the closet, a lot of stuff that's coming out will stay in the closet. Amen. But the reason why they feel comfortable coming out of the closet, amen, is because we've gone into the closet. But I'm encouraged today because no matter what man say or do, Psalms 121 tells me, first of all, that the God we serve is real. And then the psalmist tells us of some of the benefits we enjoy because we trust him and serve him because he is the true and living God. Now he, just in case the world has forgotten, he is the creator of the heavens and the earth. Now, what this means is that we exist because of him. You see, it's not the other way around. He exists because of us, but we exist because of him.
Now, this 121st psalm was a song that the Israelites sang as they made their way to Jerusalem for one of the Jerusalem feasts that they had to attend once every year. Now, the writer of this psalm is unknown. Some say it's Hezekiah. Some say it's David. But the author is not important. But it's the message that's important to us. And that message is clear that we can depend on God. So there are four things that the psalmist tells us about God that turns into benefits for those who would dare trust in him. Keep your Bibles open. The first benefit of trusting God is in verses 1 and 2. And there it tells us God is our helper. Now, verse 1 looks like a statement which says, I will lift mine eyes unto the hills. But in essence, it's not a statement, but it's a question. The psalmist is asking the question, shall I lift my eyes unto the hills? You see, as the pilgrims would make their way to Jerusalem, they would pass the hills where idol worship took place. They could look up on the hills and see the groves where the heathen worshiped their idol God. You see, the heathens trusted in gods that they made with their own hand. They looked like what they wanted them to look like. And they fashioned them by the hands of man. But guess what? That means that their self-made God, their homemade God, had only the power that they gave it. Can I get a witness? You do know that God has power whether we give it to him or not. Now, Jeremiah 3 and 23 says, truly in vain is salvation hoped for from the hills and from the multitude of mountains. But because the psalmist knew that his help was not in the hills and his help didn't come from the hills, he knew that his help came from beyond the hills. That's the reason why in verse number 2, he said, my help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. Now, to look to the hills is to trust in what you see. But to look beyond the hill is to trust in the Lord. It is to trust in the one that you can't see, but you know he's real because he's the creator of the heavens and the earth. Now, some people trust in a what, but I trust in a who. Can I get a witness? And you see, this who is the one who made the heavens and the earth. Now, the psalmist refers to the Lord as his helper. As helper, God makes the journey easier. As helper, God may not remove the journey, but he'll give us what we need to make the journey. As helper, he does not always remove the problems, but he gives us what we need to solve the problem. As helper, God walks with us through the shadow of death. The songwriter said, he walks with me. He talks with me, and he tells me that I am his own. As helper, God alone has both the power and the will to assist us in everything. Now, when the psalmist says in verse 2, which made heaven and earth, he's saying that if God can take nothing and create the heavens and the earth by simply a spoken word, He said, surely he can take care of me. Can I get a witness? You see, Genesis tells us that he stepped out on nothing and he began to speak and a world came into existence. What I like about God is that he spoke and birds began to fly. He spoke and the water separated itself from the land. He spoke and everything came into existence. But when it came to man, he could have spoken a man into existence, but he didn't. The scripture said that he, from the dust of the earth, not even dirt, but dust of the earth, he fashioned a man. It didn't say that after he finished, that he backed up and spoke and said, get up. But he took time and he blew into him the breath of life. And man became a living soul. So if God will take all of that care to create me, then surely he can take care of me. So the first benefit that we see is that God is our helper. Secondly, the psalmist tells us in verses 3-4 that God is our keeper. As the keeper, the first thing the psalmist tells us is that God will not suffer thy foot to be moved. In other words, where God places us, nobody can displace us. God is the one who causes us to be sure-footed wherever we are. You see, where God orders our steps, nobody can rearrange our steps. Nobody can redirect our steps because God is the one who orders our steps. And man cannot change it. People will try and trip us up. They would even place stumbling blocks in our path. But because God is the one who orders our steps, he will not suffer our foot to be moved. For he knows how to lead us over every hill and mountain. He knows how to move us around every trap that has been set for us. I might not see the trap, but I serve a God who is an all-seeing God. Also, the psalmist is saying that while God does not always keep trouble from us, and he does not always keep us from trouble, you do know that he could, but he does not always do it. But when he allows trouble to show up, he will not allow trouble to grab hold of us. Can I get a witness? To grab hold of us means that whatever has grabbed us is now in control of us. But God would not allow your troubles to control you. Now the word keep in the Greek means to cause a state or condition to remain. Because God is our keeper, he causes us to remain where he has placed us. No matter the storms that come our way. Can I get a witness? How many of you know that in this life you'll face life's storm? The story is told of a tree farmer who planted trees for a living. And one day, A storm came, and with very fierce winds, it began to blow and to tear up everything in its path. When the storm was over, big oaks that had stood for years and years were snapped in half, and others were uprooted and lay on the ground. But there stood a tree that had only been planted for a few years, that it survived the storm. Puzzled by the fact that that tree had withstood the storm. And those that had been around for 50 or 60 years were snapped in half or uprooted. The farmer couldn't understand how that tree that had only been planted for a few years had survived. So he decided to investigate to find out why that tree was still standing. So he took a shovel, began to dig around the tree, to dig around its roots. He kept on digging. He kept on digging until he found out why the tree had survived. You see, deep down in the ground was a big rock. And that little tree had wrapped its roots around that rock that was deep in the earth. You see, because its roots were wrapped around the rock, the storm came. It bent, but it did not break. It bent, but it was not uprooted. All because it had wrapped its roots around the rock. You see, when God orders our steps, the storms of life will bend us. The storms of life will break us. But we won't be uprooted because God has ordered our steps. The psalmist tells us that as our keeper, God never slumbers nor sleep. In other words, God does not get tired. He's never tempted to fall asleep. He's always awake and alert. By use of the words slumber and sleep, the psalmist lets us know that God is guarding us at all times. He's never distracted by anything, and nothing never detracts him or draws his attention away from us. No matter how many others God is watching, no matter how many he's keeping, guess what? God is always watching over you. Can I get a witness? Aren't you glad that you serve a God who never grows tired, who never gets weary? You know, folk get tired of our phone calls. Can I get a witness? They say, he's bothering me. But I'm glad that I can call him early in the morning. I can call him in the noonday. I can call him in the evening. I can call him at midnight, but he never gets tired of hearing from his children. So God is our helper, but he's also our keeper. Thirdly, the psalmist tells us in verses 5 through 6 that God is our protector. Now the word keeper here in verse 5 is different from the words he that keepeth in verses 3 through 4. Remember in verses 3 and 4, keepeth means to cause a state or condition to remain. Here in verse 5, keeper means protector. It means one who manages or looks after something or somebody. You see, God looks out for his children. He's our shade upon our right hand. You see, the right hand is the side of protection. But it's also the place of need. Can I get a witness? So because he's on our right side, he's there to protect us in our hour of need. Here, the word shade also means guide. In other words, God is our guide. Just as God guided the Israelites through the desert by a cloud by day and a pillar of fire by night, the shade represents his guidance throughout life's journey. You see, the pillar of fire and the cloud signified God's protection upon the children of Israel. But the pillar of fire and the cloud also signified the presence of God with Israel. You see, everybody knew that not only did God protect Israel, but he was present with them also. You see, there are some things that the enemy would love to do to you and I. But he can't do it because God is present in our life. You see, you and I can't see the hedge of protection that God has placed around us. But guess what? The enemy can. And he knows because it's there. He's limited to what he can do to you and I. You remember Job? Satan told God, the reason I can't get to him is because you've got a hedge around him. Can I get a witness? He said, if you remove that hedge, I'll make him curse you to your face. God moved the hedge and Satan took everything Job had. But Job maintained his integrity. Because I believe that Job knew who God was. Can I get a witness? If it were not for the unseen hedge around you and I, the enemy would have already taken us down. Some of us, he would already have taken us out. But I thank God for his hedge. Now, some theologians believe that the shade in verse 5 protected the traveler from the sun and the moon talked about in verse 6. You see, while the sun did get hot upon the traveler during the day, and the moon did make some folk act funny when it was full at night, I believe the psalmist had something else in mind. I believe that by use of the sun and the moon, the psalmist was talking about 24-hour protection. He was talking about God's protection from the events or things that take place under the sun and the moon. Things that can happen during the day, the sun, or things that can happen during the night, the moon. Now, while we go about our daily routine each day, God is there. Thank God he's there. protecting us. While we sleep at night, in the very image of death, God is there watching over us and protecting us. God is our 24-hour day keeper. Can I get a witness? See, I can't watch my house 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. But I'm glad I serve a God who can. Can I get a witness? Now, I've never seen God with my naked eye. But guess what? I know that he's real. You may ask me how I know he's real. Every now and then, I feel a little will down on the inside that begins to move, that lets me know that my God is real. The psalmist tells me, the Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is thy shade upon thy right hand. The sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night, because God is my shade. I tell you, the Lord is our helper. The Lord is our keeper. And the Lord is our protector. Lastly, the psalmist tells us in verses 7 and 8 that God is our preserver. The word preserver means to maintain in its original or existing state. It also means to keep safe from harm or injury. Here, the psalmist tells us that God will keep us wherever we go or wherever we may be. You see, Israel didn't always obey God, but he preserved them. In other words, they were still his chosen people in spite of their actions. Sometimes they disobeyed God. Sometimes they turned their backs on him. Sometimes they forgot about the God who had brought them out of bondage into the land of promise. But because he is a preserver, he still called them his chosen people. Sometimes he allowed them to go away into captivity, but he preserved them and still called them his chosen people. We must understand that we don't always do everything that God has told us to do. We don't always walk like God wants us to walk. We don't always talk like God wants us to talk. We don't always go to the places God wants us to go. But I'm glad that even when I miss the mark, I'm still a blood-bought, blood-washed child of the Most High God. Because it's not always about whether I'm doing everything that I should do, but it's about I'm covered in the blood of the Lamb. I love the fact that the psalmist said, the Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in from this time forth. That means that God will take care of me for as long as I'm walking in time. Can I get a witness? But I'm glad that the psalmist didn't stop there. He said, but not only will he take care of me in time, Not only will it be from this time forth, he said, but for evermore. You see, what he did was he passed time and went on over to eternity. Can I get a witness? Because he wanted us to know that just like he's the God of time, he's also the God of eternity. Can I get a witness? I'm glad, so glad, that Jesus prepared a place for me. Can I get a witness? In St. John chapter 14, Jesus said, in my Father's house there are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. He said, I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go, I'll come again and receive you unto myself. Can I get a witness? Over 2,000 years ago, he left and went back to heaven so that one day, when it's all over, I can go to be with him. If you should miss me from praying down here, if you should miss me from singing down here, if you should miss me from preaching down here, come on up. Come on up to Glory Land. You'll find me somewhere around God's throne. The benefits of trusting in God. He's our helper. He's our keeper. He's our protector. And he is our preserver.
Let the church say amen. Amen. Let's say amen again. Amen. God is, and trusting in him, and the benefits of trusting in him. The word has gone forth. Now it's left up to someone under the sound of our voice. As the ministers are standing, the deacons are standing, there may be one today, because trusting him, receiving the benefits from him, is about having a relationship with him. So if there's one today, candidate for baptism, by letter of Christian experience, we invite you today, as this choir sings, would you come? Is there one?
Father, you know we need it.
Is there one today willing to walk the aisle?
Come on, Clark. That's right.
Invitation has been given. It is our prayer that each and every one under the sound of our voice truly have the
Thank you for joining us by live streaming for our worship service today. We are now in the process of extending an invitation in our sanctuary, but I want to also extend an invitation to you, our viewers, if you don't know Jesus Christ in the pardon of your sins, that you might get to know him today. The Bible tells us in Romans chapter 10, verses 9 and 10, that if thou wilt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and believe in thine heart that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. So if you are a non-believer and you would like to confess Jesus Christ, if you want to become a Christian today, all you have to do is confess with your mouth and believe in your heart. And it's just that simple. You are saved. Also, if you're interested in having us to pray for you, you can visit our website. There's a place there for you to submit a prayer request, or if you're interested in becoming a member of the Friendship Baptist Church in the colony, you can also visit our website, and there is a place there for you to make that request also. But most of all, thank you for joining us today via live streaming as we worship our God in spirit and in truth. May God bless you and keep you, and may you have a blessed week.
Amen. We thank God for what he has done here today.